Hey guys, hope you're all doing well. Now for today's video, I want to talk about one of the most interesting and insane hybrids from the entire Jurassic Park franchise. Recently, I made a video that went into detail about something called Project Evolution. This was a Halloween horror event from 2002 that came complete with a new Jurassic Park attraction that featured a mad scientist named Dr. Burton, along with his terrifying dinosaur-human hybrid creations. Well, in that video, I made it clear that I was leaving one hybrid creature out for a deeper dive later on. And well, that creature is the subject matter of today's video. Now, if you've clicked on the thumbnail, I'm sure you already have a ton of questions about this animal. So I'm not going to waste any time and just go ahead and jump into it. This creature is known only as the Grepnadu. And for years it sat on Jurassic Park fan site wikis, and very little was ever really known about it outside from the fact that it appeared in Project Evolution. And as wild and crazy as this thing looks, I'm sure a lot of dinosaur purists were scratching their heads wondering what exactly this guy's genetic makeup happened to be. Well, after Chris Pugh from Jurassic Outpost convinced me, I reached out to the man responsible for this clone's creation, and that would be none other than the visual effects artist Jim Udenberg. And wow, let me tell you, Jim really schooled me on everything there was to know about this guy, which should come as no surprise since he was the one that actually created it. So, here are the facts. Jim was the supervisor of the makeup and prosthetics department of Universal Orlando in 2002. Now, when he and the others started getting information on that year's Halloween horror event, they specifically asked him to create a, quote, sea serpent type of creature. This hybrid was going to be operated like a hand puppet, and they wanted it to pop out of the bushes and scare people on the tour. And here's where something really interesting was asked of him. The only direction that he was ever given was that they wanted the creature to be snake-like, with some references to, get this, the famous sandworms known as graboids in the Tremors series. So Jim got to work and did a bunch of quick sketches before detailing a lot of the final design. His creation was actually completed early on for the most part, with the exception of a last minute change on the nose area. You see, originally the Grepnadu had more of a snake-like anatomy before he saw the beak-like mouth of an octopus. And just before he turned the design in, he quickly changed the nose area to a more powerful upper beak, which could grab a hold of its prey and hold it tight with the help of its already muscular jaw and razor-sharp teeth. The dangling appendages on the side of his head were inspired by anglerfish, but they're actually supposed to be sensory organs instead of something that would have the ability to lure prey with light. As for the creature's name, it's just Udenberg spelled backwards, which is pretty clever. It happened to be a light joke with one of the directors behind the scenes that wound up sticking. Now, Jim told me outright that the hybrid wasn't based on any sort of animal from the fossil record or really any specific previous design, but he did take a lot of inspiration from a variety of different creatures in the animal kingdom. He feels it's important to keep things like this organic and believable no matter what you're making. He wound up designing two of these creatures for the Halloween horror event, which were made out of latex, but he also had a silicon one created specifically for himself, which sits in his home proudly on display, which is something I know I personally would totally do if I was ever given the chance to create an animal for Jurassic Park. Jim also happens to have a big old spitting Dilophosaurus head hanging up like a hunting trophy in his home, and if that doesn't scream massive Jurassic fan, I really don't know what does. But to run down everything that we learned real quick, the Grepnadu was a genetically hybridized creature created by Dr. Burton for the insane Project Evolution. Its design was recommended to be heavily influenced by the graboids from Tremors, and Mr. Udenberg used a lot of sea and snake-like creatures to personally inspire him when creating the beast. During the event, it would pop out of the bushes and scare people whenever they unsuspectingly walked by. Oh, by the way, when it did that, compressed air would get sprayed on the guests through little nozzles that were installed in the Grepnadu's head. Talk about pretty cool effects work. Now, I want to thank Jim for giving me the rundown on this thing because I personally believe it to be one of the most unique and wild-looking hybrids in the entire franchise. You would never see this in a movie, and I honestly think more people should see this thing ASAP. It was a real pleasure to hear directly from the source everything there is to know about the incredibly rare and deadly clone known as the Grepnadu. Now guys, what do all of you think of it? What are your thoughts and opinions on this creepy, outlandish, prehistoric beast? Also, have you ever heard of this thing before in the past? I want to know. And what did you think when you heard that it was suggested to be inspired by the monsters from Tremors? That kind of blew me away. Jurassic Park and Tremors on the same frequency? What the hell was going on? Now, whatever your own thoughts and opinions happen to be, I'd love to hear all of them in the comments down below. Now before I go, I'd like to thank all of my game wardens, as well as all of my engine executives. I'd also like to thank all of my park workers and engine hunters as well. It really means the world to me that all of you continue to watch my videos, and I never want any of you to forget that. Now, I'd like to thank all of you for watching today's video, and hope you all enjoyed the content. If you feel like I deserve it, I'd appreciate the like, and hope that you'll consider subscribing if you're interested in hearing from me again. See you all in the next video, guys, and as always, take it easy.